Here's a quick look at the local corporate headlines we're watching this morning. Rockwell Land has secured a 5 billion peso term loan facility with BDO, which it will use for capex, land acquisition, and other investments. And for those who missed it, this came out after trading hours yesterday. Integrated Microelectronics widening its group net loss to $109.2 million for 2023 from just a net loss of $6.8 million the year before. The company cited among the reasons for this would be the shorter fiscal year of STI Enterprises, which was divested back in October last year, losses from that sale, one-time losses, impairment of goodwill, and certain assets. Meanwhile, wholly owned subsidiaries maintained the momentum for the year with revenues on par with the previous year and better profitability margins, netting a reported net income of $13 million. Again, that $13 million net income is for the core businesses, which includes wholly owned subsidiaries. And Jollibee Foods, wholly owned subsidiary Jollibee Worldwide, participating in Titan Fund 2. The fund size will be 100 million Singaporean dollars, which will be used to fund strategic investments in food and beverage with the objective to further grow Asia-Pac food service brands. Jollibee Worldwide will have 90% participating interest in Titan Fund 2 with a capital commitment of 90 million Singaporean dollars. Small borrowers are expected to benefit from a new credit line facility that AsiaLink Finance secured from Taiwan's Cathay United Bank. The online lending company says it has secured a fresh 300 million peso credit line from Cathay United after earlier securing a line from two other Taiwanese banks, CTBC Bank and Yuan Tai Savings Bank. It says the money will help it grow its customer base and allow it to reach more individual lenders and small and medium enterprises with little to no access to traditional sources of funding. Now, last year, it expanded its loan footprint into the fast-growing auto market for brand new and used trucks for logistics. In 2023, AsiaLink disbursed over 11 billion in loans and ended the year with close to 27,000 new borrowers. The Philippine Customs Bureau beat its collections target for March. Customs collected 75.4 billion pesos, surpassing its 72.9 billion target by over 3%. However, March's collection is still 6% lower year-on-year. For the first quarter, the agency collected 220 billion. That's bigger than the 211 billion it planned to collect. This is also higher than last year's collection of 214 billion pesos. The BOC attributes this to its strict monitoring and collection of deferred payment of government imports for the increase in collections. DigiPlus earmarking as much as 2 billion pesos for capex this year to sustain its growth momentum and ramp up its digital offerings. The listed digital entertainment company, which is behind Bingo Plus and Peria Game, says more than half of that budget will go to technological upgrades, including cybersecurity. DigiPlus recently launched Color Game, which uses the traditional Filipino carnival games as a setting. It also launched Bingo Plus Poker and Tong Its Plus, which allows users to play the card game without wagering real money. DigiPlus, one of 2023's top performing stocks, recorded a net 4.1 billion pesos of profit last year. That's up nearly 600% year-on-year, driven by the steady growth of its digital retail segment. The Philippine National Railway is seeking more funds from the national government. It says the additional money will be used to provide bus fare subsidies to passengers affected by the five-year suspension of its train services, which was done to make way for the construction of the North-South Commuter Railway. The suspension displaced some 20,000 daily commuters, forcing them to take buses instead. But passengers have been complaining taking a bus is more expensive and causes delays in their travel.